The last video, the fourth video in the chapter called as production team organism. Here we are going to consider last year we have started with gametogenesis. Now I am going to start with the next phase in the pre-fertilization event, that is called as gamete transfer. Usually what will be happening is the gametes will be left in a medium, they will be left outside. Usually the male gametes will be motile and they will be moving towards the female gamete. Here we come across two types. In the lower organism, both the gametes will be motile, but whereas in the higher organism, usually male gametes will be motile. So in lower gametes, as the both the gametes are left into the water and the fertilization is chance of occurrence, the number of gametes produced is more in the lower organism than in the higher organism. In case of plant, what will be happening is the male gametes will be enclosed within a structure called as pollen grain, and these pollen grains will be released in a medium like air, water, or with the help of organism, the pollen grains just move and they come to the female gamete for the fertilization purpose, and the term is called as pollination. So this is about the gamete transfer. Next event in the sexual reproduction is fertilization. Now, fertilization is also termed as syngamete, in which we just call it as fusion of male and female gamete. After the fusion, it results into the formation of zygote. But there is one exception. There are few organisms like honeybees in which only gamete, instead of fusion, directly this gamete will be developed into the adult. So if there is no fertilization, only development of the gamete into the adult, this process is called as parthenogenesis and important for 1 month. Usually fertilization can be of two types. One is called as external fertilization, second one is called as internal fertilization. In external fertilization, the gametes will be fused in a medium, and further the formation of zygote happens in the water, mostly it will be water. In case of internal fertilization, it is more advantageous one. Why? Because usually here the male gamete will be transferred to the female body, and the development of zygote, instead of outside, it will be happening inside the female body. So here the zygote will be well protected, but here the zygote will be exposed to the predators. So this is more advantageous than the external fertilization. So this is very important event which leads to the formation of zygote. So after fertilization, whatever the things happen, we call them as post-fertilization. The first event is nothing but zygote. Now, I already told you, zygote is product of fusion of male and female gametes. We also call this zygote as vital link between two generations, parent and the offspring. Every living organism starts their life with a single cell called as zygote. Now this zygote, next, what it will do is, it will start dividing and formation of embryo takes place, and that process is called as embryogenesis. Now, there is one thing here to understand. I have told you that last year we have discussed about two types of life cycle. One is called as haplontic, second one is called as diplontic. Imagine, always here zygote will be diploid in nature. But if the organism originally is haploid, then this zygote has to undergo meiosis to form haploid spore, and then this haploid spore grow into the embryo. But usually, if the organism are diploid, then what will be happening is this diploid zygote just starts cell division. It will be mitosis here, and then after the division, there comes the next stage called as cell differentiation. Cell division increase the mass. Cell differentiation make different cells specialize to form the different functions. Once these things are ready, we call it as complete development of embryo, and the process is called as embryogenesis. Now, the development of zygote depends in two cases. One is oviparous, second one is viviparous. In oviparous type of organism, what will be happening is the fertilized zygote will be well covered under the calcareous shell, a calcareous covering, and these organisms, they just lay eggs, and these eggs will be hatching later and giving rise to the lemmules. But in case of viviparous, the zygote will be there inside the female body only, and the organism, the offspring, comes out as a completely developed organism, and that is called as wheat paras. Usually mammals show viviparous type of development and birds show oviparous type of development. And this is the end of the chapter, reproduction in organism. Thank you.